Good morning. How will God's end-time remnant live? Our reading is at Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 10 to 12 today. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the isles far off, and say, He who scattered Israel will gather him and keep him as a shepherd does his flock. For the Lord has redeemed Jacob and ransomed him from the hand of one stronger than he. Therefore they shall come and sing in the height of Zion, streaming to the goodness of the Lord, for wheat and new wine and oil, for the young of the flock and the herd. Their souls shall be like a watered garden, and they shall sorrow no more at all. What a picture that is that Jeremiah gives us. God's watching to help us. His church matters to him very greatly. He scattered his people to help them, and he's going to regather us to help us again. He redeemed them from one stronger than they are. The demons are all stronger than humans. Jesus intervened. God came down and he delivered us with a heavy, powerful hand. He's stronger than any weak human or any heroic human. Jesus bought his people Israel back and he's bought us back. Pharaoh tried to stand against God. Pharaoh tried to say, well, we can ignore this God. But he found out that didn't work too well. Even Nebuchadnezzar, that did such horrible things against God's people, God was stronger than him. God turned him. God knows what we need, and he knows when we need it. So we just need to hold on tight. He'll get us through. He'll walk us through every challenge, every tight and narrow place. He has a way to get us through it. He'll get you through it today. Now here Jeremiah reminds the people with many rich symbols. The wheat, the new wine, the oil. Symbols, you know, of God's ripening his harvest. The wheat and the wine reminds us of Jesus' body and blood being shed for us at the cross. The oil reminds us of the Holy Spirit, which God has in abundance for you and me today. Is he going to abandon his people at these end times? No, I don't think so. We're going to come through with abundant help from above. And our text tells us what we'll be like. The soul shall be like a well-watered garden, verse 12. So we've reached out for many things. There's many things we thought we needed, many things in our life that we are always kind of feeling we're behind on. I don't have enough of this food, I don't have enough money for rent, I don't have enough money to pay this bill, I don't have this item, I need this, I need that. There's many things we thought we needed, but what we really needed was God's word. What we really needed was the Lord Jesus Christ. He has what we need. He has the Holy Spirit that we need. And with that, we will never be poor if we have the Holy Spirit. So God will get us through, but we need to surrender to him and receive his riches. And you know, the church has spent a lot of time trying to improve on God's ways, hasn't it? I mean, let's be honest. But it hasn't gotten us very much. We need to go back to God's methods. God's methods will bring us success in his work. Human methods might bring us a moment or two of apparent success, but in the end, we'll see it was pretty shallow. It wasn't all that we thought it was. We need to go God's way. We need to go a Bible way, up on the Bible path. So God will use that, and he's going to bring us back along. How's the end-time remnant going to live? We're going to be closer to Jesus than we've been before, and we're going to see the hand of God working for us. There's wonderful things on the horizon. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, we know you have us in the palm of your hand. We know you have great plans for us. There's many miraculous and mighty things you plan to do for us and with us if we'll just be available to you. May we be available to you. Help us to be so available, Lord. And this is the thing we ask today in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, the end-time follower is going to walk closely with Christ, and we'll have a well-watered experience with him. Go out today, nourished and watered by Jesus.